Ladies and gentlemen, today we are going to be reacting to the evolution of Venom. Now, Venom is one of my favorite villains slash, I guess you would call him an anti-hero. Especially in some of the most recent movies, like in Venom, he was kind of being the good guy. So in that case, anti-hero. But anyways, he is one of my favorite. He's always looking so amazing in anything. The Spider-Man movies, the Venom movies, always awesome. But let me know which Venom is your favorite in the comments. Do you like the Spider-Man verse version of Venom? Or do you like when they just separated and made a whole Venom movie series with Carnage and all that? The video we are going to be reacting to today is titled The Evolution of Venom. I don't know how many Venoms there even are, but we're about to be learning because this video is by Tell It Animated. I'll throw him up on the screen right now so you can see him. We've reacted to his videos before and we always learn something. I mean always, so I'm only expecting to learn everything about Venom today. So let's do it, guys. Let's jump right in here and learn the entire lifeline of Venom.
Everyone
I'm ready for
Nixon
it.
Peter Parker's discarded alien symbiote with disgruntled journalist Eddie Brock.
Eddie Brock.
The beastly Venom. But just how has he changed over the years? Let's go through Venom's appearances in TV and film to find out.
That red and blue color?
Venom
I like
first
that.
Appeared on screen in the 1994 Spider-Man animated series.
1994.
He has visible pupils, luscious lips, a creased head,
ew,
large spider emblem, and white hand patches that shoot his webbing, plus constant red and blue highlights.
Okay, I really like the red and blue highlights. I don't know what it is, but the red, the blue, the black, and the white, it's all coming together. But one thing I really don't like is the top of his head. Why'd they give him a butt cheek head? They really did not have to do my man Venom like that.
On his forearms,
I'll tell you that much.
His signature long tongue.
In yep, the tongue series, signature.
Venom is much more monstrous.
Ooh.
He no longer has red highlights. He has a protruding spine, animal-like feet, and lacks any sort of pupil.
I do remember
in addition,
that Venom.
This is the first on-screen appearance of his limb-like tendrils.
Okay, I absolutely love the tentacles. What did he just call them? Tendrils? I love the tendrils slash tentacles. I love that on
He's
Venom and Carnage.
Turning into a gooey puddle, allowing him to merge with his buddy Carnage.
Wait a minute, they merged? Could you imagine, you know, in the new movie, in the Venom versus Carnage movie, could you imagine if they merged? That would have been absolutely crazy if they look like that, for sure.
Venom slims down for his live-action debut.
This
he
was a good movie.
He has a spider suit-like texture,
Spider-Man
no hand
3.
Patches, a gray emblem, and tiny sharp teeth. This version of him mostly shrieks, and when trapped by vibrating poles, he's taken out with an exploding pumpkin.
That's not a bad version, but it's definitely not my favorite.
Venom has longer arms, no white hand patches, and his stomach can apparently open up like a mouth.
Wait a minute, what? His stomach can open up like a mouth? Could you imagine him grabbing Spider-Man and just putting him in his stomach? What in the world did I just see? What was this called? Spectacular Spider-Man?
In Ultimate Spider-Man, Doc Ock creates the Venom symbiote from a sample of Spider-Man's DNA.
That's not
it's
good.
It's used by Harry Osborn to become Black Suit Spider-Man.
Black Suit Spidey.
Before its more brutish Venom form unleashes. Later on, the symbiote attaches to reformed bully Flash Thompson, turning him into the tactical superhero,
okay.
Agent Venom.
The superhero, see?
It affects a slew of other characters, but that's a whole can of goose.
Look at that Venom back there! Is that a dragon Venom? What in the... Hey, I have not seen any of those, but those do look all amazing.
So
see, I told
moving.
You we was going to learn.
In the Phineas and Ferb Marvel crossover, Venom makes a comic book accurate
Wait.
Appearance with his usual hunger for mischief.
Phineas and Ferb? You mean to tell me I missed an episode of Phineas and Ferb where Venom was in it? I used to watch that show all the time. I ain't going to lie to you. And I never saw Venom in it. That would have been an amazing episode.
In Hulk and the Agents of Smash, the
what
symbiote
the world?
Attaches to Scar, She-Hulk, A-Bomb, Red Hulk, and Regular Hulk before absorbing most of them to become the gigantic and unwieldy Gamma Venom.
I'm learning so much in this video today. You mean to tell me Venom can attach himself to multiple people and combine them together? Giga Venom? That even sounds crazy, man. I kind of need to look this up and watch that movie now. Even he connected with Red Hulk. That would be, imagine Hulk mixed with Venom. A giant, strong, very mad person. And a symbiotic, crazy, I don't even know what you would explain
the anime,
Venom
Marvel
as.
Marvel Disc Wars features another infected Hulk. But this
Who is
version
this?
Matches closer to Venom's usual form. Although his skin is lighter and
Hulk
he has
Venom.
Added veins. In the 2017 Spider-Man cartoon,
that would
Flash
be a crazy
Thompson,
thing.
Eddie Brock, and Max Modell all become
Spider-Man?
Their own respective Venom. This version of Venom has pointy elbows and upper thighs. His spider emblem extends beyond his shoulders.
Nah.
And he has sharp white nails. The Eddie Brock version has a more squished face, while the Max Modell variation...
Hold up, man. Why'd they do Venom like that? Everybody peep Venom for 1 second. He kind of looks like the Hunchback of Notre Dame. My boy is looking real beat. He needs to stretch his back, do something. I don't know what he needs to do, but he needs to do
it. Has more spiky protrusions and a longer emblem.
Once it's getting
Max
better.
Once Max gains control of the symbiote,
his
stomach mouth also makes a reappearance. Additionally, the symbiote briefly merges with Dr. Kurt Connors.
What's up with the stomach?
And can even survive without a host. During the Guardians of the Galaxy crossover, the Venom symbiote attaches to Spider-Man. Although this Venom is less stocky, and his emblem and eyes occasionally glow bright red.
That's
in
sick.
Avengers Assemble, Dracula is infected by the symbiote, which retains his armored suit, long hair, and red vampiric eyes.
Dracula mixed with Venom. Now we got a vampire mixed with Venom. Man, what is going on? I'm assuming this is like the animated series, right? Because the Marvel Avengers, I did not see Venom in there for sure. I definitely would have remembered that. But I definitely did not see him. Definitely. I did not see him in the live-action movie.
In his standalone live-action film,
so it had to be the animated
Venom
one.
Is bulky, lacks any suit texture, and has no emblem. He's strangely veiny and has two layers of teeth. This Venom also attaches to Eddie Brock's ex-girlfriend.
That Venom is my favorite.
She-Venom. In this film, Venom faces off against evil businessman Carlton Drake, who becomes the skilled symbiote Riot.
We gotta go back, man. Riot looks crazy. Hey, big shout out to Talent Animated. Look at that. Riot versus Venom. I'm not gonna lie to you. In the movie, I totally thought Riot was gonna win. I mean, just look at him. Comparing these two characters, which one do you think would win? I would pick Riot every single time. Plus, he's got a bunch of moves. What did they call him? He was like attack symbiote or fighter symbiote. I forgot what they actually called it. But he's
Riot.
One of those crazy
In
ones.
In the sequel, Venom ditches Eddie to hit the party scene.
Ouch.
Then attaches to convenience store owner Mrs. Chen.
Before Mrs. Chen.
His way back to his main man. This time, Eddie is bitten by serial killer Cletus Kasady, turning Cletus into the deranged symbiote Carnage.
Carnage is here. You know, he doesn't look great in this one. I'm not going to lie to you, but he still looks amazing from where I'm looking at him. But in the movie, guys, Carnage looked absolutely insane. And of course, he's got all those weapons. He's got so much more than Riot. I would pick Carnage over pretty much anybody. I'm not going to lie. Even though Venom did beat him.
Despite being much more powerful,
look at that. Hey, wait a minute. I paused at the wrong time. Now, this is where we should have paused, man. Everybody, check the weapons. He's got everything you could ever want. He's got swords. He's got axes. I don't even know what most of this stuff is.
He's taken down by the reunited Eddie and Venom.
But he did get taken down.
The strongest iteration of Venom is probably his Lego version.
I'm sorry. The strongest is Lego Venom? Let's go back and hear that again. I had to have heard that wrong.
But the strongest iteration of Venom is probably his Lego version.
Lego Venom?
So, which version of Venom is your favorite? And let us know what other Spidey villains you want to see get their own evolution.
Okay, wait a minute. Which Spider-Man villain would you want to see get animated in their own evolution? Me personally, if he's listening out here, I would love to see Green Goblin. That would be pretty cool. And in the comments, guys, let me know which was your favorite Venom out of all of them. You've got a bunch to choose from. You've even got Giga Venom, who I didn't even know was a thing. I learned so much during this video, guys. If you liked it, hit that like button and also that subscribe button if you haven't yet. And by the way, my favorite Venom is by far the most recent Venom, the one that mixed with Eddie Brock in the live action movie. That one was amazing. Other than that, guys, I will see you all in tomorrow's video. Thank you for watching with me. I love ya. Goodbye.